Alexia Petrovich grew up with a racket in her hand.
I started playing when I was about 9 years old and just picked it up from there. I kind of put away all the other sports I was playing. I would practice about every single day, about 2 to 3, 4 hours during the school year, but when summer came around, it would be a lot more hectic. I just love how it's kind of an individual sport and everything you do is on your own and kind of makes the competition that much more exciting.
Doctors define sports specialization as year-round intensive training at the exclusion of all other sports. It paid off for Alexia, earning her a tennis scholarship at the University of Utah, but not before threatening to bench her for good.
Using intense training in a single sport makes you end up using the same body parts over and over again and doesn't allow for some recovery and rest in those specific areas. When you have a kid who has adult level skills, but they have a developing body, they don't absorb that stress the same way that an adult or mature body would.
According to Dr. Jainthi, 90% of tennis players specialize in the sport by the time they're 16, putting them at risk for injury.
During tennis, you're required to do a lot of movements, and in the low back, you do movements which are called extension. So serving over and over and over again with your lean, you know, the way you lean back, especially in a developing body, that puts the low back at risk.
My injury happened about 2 years ago, and it was a bunch of back-to-back tournaments. Whenever I was hitting strokes or doing serves, my back just did not feel good. It was really achy, and I was in a lot of pain, and even just like moving a little bit and sitting down still like made my back hurt. I finally got it checked out, and I realized I had a stress fracture, and at that point, it was best for me to just take time off and kind of rest it.
Alexia had a full recovery thanks to rest and rehab.
She actually got full bony healing, and this is a less common injury as you go off into college and older. So I think if she maintains her strengthening program, watches her training volume like she has, and work with excellent coaches like she has, I think she'll do very well, and I think the chance that she'll have a recurrence is pretty low.
Dr. Jainthi says it's important to follow 3 rules of thumb to avoid injury.
The general rule is that we would like kids to delay early specialization till maybe 12 or 14 years old. Number 2 would be, based on our research findings, we find that playing in organized sports less than twice as much as your amount you play in free play. So trying to increase the amount of recreational fun free play would be good. And then the 3rd one we found is that we want you to do less hours per week in your sport than your actual age. So if you're 10 years old, do less than 10 hours a week.
My advice to other athletes would be, if you're ever feeling any sort of pain at all, to definitely stop and don't try to push through it, because eventually that could just make it worse. Take the time off that you need and it'll probably help you more in the long run.